So, hello students, welcome to the new session or new video. Today we will be discussing about problem on finding out the velocity, linear velocity as well as angular velocity using instantaneous center method. Okay, it is a bit complex mechanism which is given here. So as you can see, the mechanism is given, it is there in front of you. So let us read the question first. A mechanism as shown in figure has the following dimensions. OA, okay, which is the crank, is 200 millimeter, AB 1.5 millimeter, BC 600 millimeter, CD 500 millimeter. Mr. Manat, yeah, 500 millimeter and BE 400 millimeter. Locate all the ICs. If the crank OA rotates uniformly at 120 RPM clockwise, find the velocity of BC and D, angular velocity of links AB, CD and BC. So this is the given mechanism, as you can see in front of you. So OA is the crank, which is rotating about a fixed point O. Okay, then there is another link AB. Then the link B is connected to C. So that is, there is another link BC, which passes through a fixed point E, Then we have another link CD. At the end of CD, we have a slider. So the given dimensions, use the given dimensions and draw the configuration diagram. Before that, you need to analyze or take down the data given. So OA, as we know, 200 millimeter, AB 1.5 meters, OE 1.35 meters, BC 600 millimeter, CD 500 millimeter, BE 400 NOA. That is the speed of the crank. Rotation of the crank is given as 120 RPM. So once you know the speed of the rotation of the crank, so you can find out the omega OA or omega A. Okay, so let us move on to the first step, that is the configuration diagram. So we have the data or the dimensions. Using that, we can draw the configuration diagram. So take the scale as per your comfort. So before that, find out omega OA or omega A. So that is given by 2 pi NOA by 60. So when you input the data here, that is N value here, 120, you can get the omega value, that is 12.57 radians per second. So once you obtain omega, you can easily find out VA value. That is, VA is equal to omega OA into the link length OA. So that will give us the value 2.514 meter per second for VA. Okay, now draw the configuration diagram as per the given dimensions and as per your comfort, take the scale. Okay, this is the configuration diagram. Now locate the links. So link one, fixed link. Similarly, you have E, that is a link one. Again, slider will slide on a fixed link, that is link one. So this is link two. OA is considered as link two. AB is considered as link three. BC is considered as link four. CD is considered as link five. And the slider is considered as link six. So we have total six number of links here. So we know the formula to calculate number of instantaneous centers, correct? So that is capital N is equal to small n into n minus 1 divided by 2. So here the number of links are 6. So 6 into 6 minus 1 divided by 2 will be 15. Will give the value 15. Okay. So once you know the total number of ICs which can be located in the given mechanism, you move on and find the ICs, or first take down the ICs which can be located. Okay. So as you can see, there is a link one. Okay, so link one and two will have an IC I12 over there at point O. And at point A, link two and three will have an IC I23. At point B, okay, link three and four will have an IC I34. At point C, okay, you will be having I45. At the slider at point there, you'll be having a link I56. Okay, so now we need to find out the remaining links, or we need to locate the remaining links. Only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 links are, 5 ICs are located as of now. So first of all, let us note down which are the ICs to be spotted or located. So I12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, so total number of links 6. So therefore, so then 2 is already combined with 1. So therefore, I23, 24, 25, 26. Then 3 is combined with 2 already. So therefore, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6. Then we have I45 and 46. And then finally we have I56. So total number of ICs to be located, 15. Total number of ICs to be located, 15. In these ICs, we have located 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 ICs. That is I12, 23, 34, 45, and 56. Okay, so this is how you need to locate the available ICs initially. Then you need to go for finding out or locating the unknown ICs. Okay, so here we will use a circle method only, but we will not draw a square or we will not draw a rectangle in the circle. Okay, because total number of links are 6. So therefore, we will draw a hexagon. We will draw a hexagon and locate the points. Okay, draw a circle first, then cut the circle into 6 equal parts, or okay, you can just cut 6. Okay, just like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So join all the points. Okay, and I'm named them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so locate the ICs which we have already noted down, or which we have in the mechanism, which can be spotted or which can be located in the mechanism, given mechanism. So that is 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, and 1, 6. Okay, so 1, 6, I'll just show you. So as in the previous problem, we have discussed, okay, when there is a slider and when it is moving with respect to a fixed point, okay, we can locate instantaneous center perpendicular to the fixed link or fixed point. Okay, fixed link, that is link 1. So at infinity. So that is, so first link is fixed. So we have the sixth link, that is the slider. So we can draw perpendicular lines to all the fixed links and show the IC16. Okay, because first link is fixed and the last link is the slider. So I16 at infinity like this. I16 at infinity like this. So you have to remember this. Once again, I'll tell you. So as discussed in the previous problem and as we are discussing now in this problem. So when we have a fixed link, first link is fixed and the last link is a slider. Okay, slider slides with respect to the fixed link, first link. So the IC with respect to the IC of link 6 with respect to the link 1, that is fixed link, is drawn perpendicular to all the fixed links given in the mechanism and shown as shown in this diagram, that is I16 at infinity. Okay, so this is how we need to locate I16. Now, it is a complex thing. Just see and observe and understand. So 1,4 is also known to us. 1,4 is also known to us, correct? That is, as you can see, link 1, see here, link 1 and link 4. Link 1 and link 4, both of them have the IC here at this particular point. Link 1 and link 4, both of them lie on the same line. Therefore, we have an IC here at this point. Okay, so this is I14. This is also known. So connect 1 to 4. So connect 1 to 4. Just draw a straight line and connect 1 to 4. Now we need to find out the ICs which are unknown to us, or we need to locate the ICs which are unknown to us. Okay. So first let us take 2,4. Okay, let us locate the IC 2,4. So for that, what we should do, we should connect 2 to 4, correct? We should connect 2 to 4. So when you connect 2 to 4, so this 2, 4 line is surrounded by two triangles. One is 1, 2 and 1, 4. So another one is 2, 3 and 3, 4. 1, 2 and 1, 4, 2, 3 and 2, 4. So where is 1, 2 and 1, 4? So as you can see, this is 1, 2, this is 1, 4. See, this is 1, 2 and this is 1, 4. Both lie on the same line. So where is 2, 3 and 3, 4? See, this is 2, 3. As you can see here, this is 2, 3 and this is 3, 4. So both of these lines, okay, 1, 2, 1, 4 and 2, 3, 3, 4, intersect at this particular point wherein we can locate the instantaneous center 2, 4. Instantaneous center 2, 4. Correct? So we have located the instantaneous center 2, 4. Hope you have understood this. Next, we need to find out 1, 3. Let us say instantaneous center 1, 3. So I'll draw a line 1, 2, 3. So this is also surrounded by two triangles. One is 1, 2 and 2, 3. 1, 2 and 2, 3. And other one, 1, 4 and 4, 3. Or 3, 4. 1, 4 and 3, 4. So let us go back to the configuration diagram and let us search for the ICs which lie in the same line. Okay, so see, this is 1, 4. Okay, 1, 4, 3, 4, 1, 2, 2, 3. So 1, 4, 3, 4. So this is the line on which they lie. So extend this line. So extend this line. And this is the line where 1, 2 and 2, 3 are lying, correct? 1, 2 and 2, 3 lie in the same line. Extend the line here. Now, 1, 3, 4 and 1, 4, okay, lie on this line. So extend this. Wherever these two lines intersect, wherever these two lines intersect, that is your new IC, that is 1, 3, I, 1, 3. Okay, second IC is also found. Okay, next, let us move on to the next IC to be located. That is, so let us put a tick on this so that we have found it out. So next, let us found a new IC. Let us say we have to find I25. Okay, I25. Okay, now what I'll do is, or I26, let us say. Or 15, let us find out. 15. Let us find out 15. So join 1 to 5. So this line is covered or surrounded by two triangles, 1445, 1614. 1445. See, 1445, 1614. Okay. One, four, four, five, and 1614. So you have to remember this and go back to the, sorry, this is 1445. Yeah, 14. Let us first find 1445. See, this is 14, this is 45. You can just extend that line. And second thing is 16 and 56. So where is 16? So this is 16. This is 16, this is 16, this is 56. This is 56. Okay, this is 56. So 16, 56. And this is 16. So 16 and 56 is here. 1445 we need to see. So 1445. So see here, this is 56 and 16. This is 14 and 45. This is 14 and 45. So what I'm going to do is, I'll draw a line below. I'll draw a line below. And then I'll extend this line 145. Sorry, 14 and yeah, this line. So they'll meet at a point. So that is the intersection point, and that is the new IC 15. The new IC 15. 1, 4, 4, 5, 1, 6, 1, 4. 4, 5. So extend it, you'll get a new IC 1, 5. Okay, now you can find out 4, 6 also in the same way or in the same fashion. Okay, just connect 6 to 4 or 4 to 6. It is again surrounded by two triangles. Okay, 4, 6 is the new IC we need to find out or we need to locate. So 4, 6 is surrounded by two triangles. 1, 6, 1, 4. 1, 6, 1, 4 and 5, 6, 4, 5 or 5, 4. Okay, 4, 5 and 4, 6. So 4, 5 is here. As you can see, so this is a bit a complex mechanism. Just concentrate and find out the ICs. So this is 4, 5, 4, 6, 1, 6, 1, 4. Yeah, see, this is the line. As you can see here, see 4, 5, 5, 6. So this is 1, 4 and 1, 6. So this is the point of intersection. So you can get the 4, 6. That is IC I 4, 6. Now let us find out a new or locate new instantaneous center. Connect 2 to 6. Connect 2 to 6. When you connect 2 to 6, so it will be surrounded by two triangles. One is 1, 2 and 1, 6. As you can see, 1, 2 and 1, 6, whereas the other triangle will be 2, 4 and 4, 6. 2, 4 and 4, 6. 1, 2, 1, 6 and 2, 4, 4, 6. Okay, so see here, 1, 1, 2, 1, 6, 2, 4 and 4, 6. 1, 2, 1, 6, 2, 4 and 4, 6. So get back to the configuration diagram. So here you can see 1, 2, okay, and 1, 6. This is the line 1, 2 and 1, 6. Then 2, 4. 2, 4. Just a minute. We will try to make it out. So this is 1, 2 and 1, 6. This is 2, 4, yeah, 1, 4, 1, 6. I'll just draw a line below. Say, yeah, this is 2, 4 and 4, 6, correct? So this is 4, 6 here. So this is 2, 4, this is 4, 6. Now connect a line from 4, 6 to 2, 4 and extend it till it intersects the line 1, 2, 1, 6. So this is a new point and new AIC, that is 2, 6. That is 2, 6. Okay, this is how we need to concentrate. And first of all, it's a complex diagram. It's a complex mechanism which is having 6 links. Therefore, try to concentrate and get the ICs Okay, so now if you want, you can again find out 2 to 5. See here, connect 2 to 5. So it is surrounded by two triangles. So 2, 5, it is surrounded by two triangles. 2, 6, 5, 6. Then 2, 4, 4, 5. Or you can consider 2, 1. Wait a minute. So 2, 4, 4, 5. 1, 2, 1, 5. See, 1, 2, 1, 5. 2, 4, 4, 5. So this is 1, 2. There is 1, 5. 1, 2, 1, 5, 2, 4, 4, 5. See, this is 4, 5, and this is 1, 2. This is 1, 5. Two, four, and 4, 5. 2, 4 and 4, 5. Okay. So you can connect 12 to 15, and you can connect 45 to 24. They will meet at a point somewhere here. See, 24 to 45. Just draw a line and connect 12 to 15. They will intersect at a point somewhere here, and that is the new IC. Okay, 25. That is the new IC 25. So this much is more than enough for calculating the angular velocities as well as the linear velocity, I think. So we will stop finding out the ICs. If you want, you can find out the ICs also. No problem with that. The remaining ICs can also be found out, but it will go out of the frame or out of the sheet. So therefore, this is more than enough to find out the velocities. So now no need to locate the remaining ICs. As it's enough to find required velocities. Enough to find required velocities. Okay, now let us find out the velocities. We know that. So omega AB is equal to VA by. So we have to find the AB. So this is A and this is B. The common thing is, the common IC is 13. The common IC is 13. So therefore, VA by I13 into A, VB by I13 into B. Similarly, omega BC is equal to VA by I14, I think. So the common ICs will be for link BC. For link BC, it is I14, correct? For link BC, it is I14. Yeah, see here, I14, link BC, common IC is I14. So VB by I14B is equal to VC by I14C. Similarly, for omega CD, so VC by I15C is equal to VD by I15C. That is the common for this link is, so I15C here for BC, CD. See, this is the common IC. This is the common IC. So VC by I15B, I15C is equal to VD by I15D. So now you need to measure I13A, I13B, I14B and I14C, I15C and I15D. So using that, and we know VA, we know the value of VA. So substitute that, you can find out VB. Once you find out VB, substitute that here. Okay. And find out omega. Once you find out omega BC, you can find out VC from this relation. Okay. Once you find out VC, input the VC value here in this relation so that you can find out omega CD. So once you find out omega CD, use this relation. VD by I15D is equal to omega CD and find out VD. So this is how we need to solve a complex given mechanism. So with the help of ICs or with the help of instantaneous center method. Hope you have understood the logic behind this particular problem or this particular method. Okay, you can, whenever you want, you can just rewind the video and you can just see and understand. All right, so three problems are more than enough under this method. You can solve any number of problems, any type of link given, using the same method which we have used now, which we have used in this particular problem. So that's all for now. We will meet in the next video, wherein I'll be discussing about the other method, that is the Klein's construction. That will be the last video of this module. So thank you very much, guys.